Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on the subject Engineering Thermodynamics. This is Module 3. We are discussing on second law of thermodynamics. This is lecture number 305. And we recap from the previous lecture. In the previous lecture 304, we discussed the Clausius theorem and we defined the property entropy and we proved that entropy is a point function and property of the system. And here in this lecture, we are going to discuss the inequality of Clausius, entropy change in an irreversible path, entropy principle and entropy generation. The learning outcome for this lecture, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to explain Clausius inequality and the student will be able to calculate entropy change of thermodynamic processes and student will be able to define entropy generation and the student will be able to state the third law of thermodynamics. First, we take the inequality of Clausius statement. Now, we consider a process A, B, C, D. So, A, the curved path is A, B. C, it is reversible adiabatic process. C to D, it is reversible isothermal process. And then, D to A. So, A, B, C, D is a cycle, general cycle. So, here A, B is a general process, whether this may be a reversible process or irreversible process. The other processes C, B, C, C, D and D, A, they are reversible process. So, B, C is the reversible adiabatic process, C, D is the reversible isothermal process and D, A is the reversible adiabatic process. And we draw number of parallel lines, reversible adiabatic lines and the entire cycle A, B, C, D is divided into number of cycles. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cycles. First, we take the curved path. So, this curved path, the equivalent straight line we are drawing. So, this is again isothermal line. Now, this becomes the first elementary cycle. So, there are 5 elementary cycles here. So, combining all the 5 elemental cycles, then it will give the AB cycle ABCD. For one elementary cycle, for first elementary cycle, so, eta equal to 1 minus dq2 by dq. So, dq2 is the amount of heat rejected from the cycle at a temperature T2 and del q is the amount of heat given to the cycle at the temperature T. So, efficiency of one elementary cycle is eta is equal to 1 minus del q2 divided by del q. The efficiency of general cycle is less than or equal to the efficiency of reversible cycle. So, we studied earlier, the efficiency of the general cycle is less or equal to the reversible efficiency of the reversible cycle. So, the efficiency of the general cycle 1 minus del q2 divided by del q is less than or equal to 1 minus del q2 by del q for a reversible process. So, this is what the mathematical statement of the statement 1 minus del q2 by del q is the efficiency of a general cycle which is less than or equal to 1 minus del q2 by del q of a reversible cycle. So, the 1 is removed. So, 1 minus. So, the 1 is removed. Now, the symbol is changing direction. Del q2 by del q is greater than or equal to del q2 by del q reversible process. Now, we take the reciprocal. Both side we take the reciprocal. One side the once again the symbol is changing. Del q by del q2 is less than or equal to del q by del q2 for reversible path, for reversible cycle. So, del q by del q2 for reversible cycle is equal to T by T2. From the absolute temperature scale, definition of absolute temperature scale for reversible cycle, del q by del q2 equal to T by T2. So, del q by, so now you substitute here in this equation. So del q by del q2 is less than or equal to t by t2. So rearranging, del q by t is less than or equal to del q2 by t2 for any process AB, or whether this is irreversible or reversible process. So we take the general equation and we conclude that del q by t is less than or equal to del q2 by t2 for any process AB, whether this is reversible process or irreversible process. For reversible process, del q by t for reversible process equal to ds, change in entropy. So del q2 by t2 equal to ds. So for process AB, del q by t, so here I have, we have del q by t is less than or equal to del q2 by t2. So what we defined here, del q2 by t2 equal to ds. So del q by t is less than or equal to ds. For then for any cycle, integrate. So for integrating, so this is for a particular process, for cycle, cyclic integral of del q by t is less than or equal to cyclic integral of ds. So the cyclic integral, so for, since entropy is a property and the cyclic integral of any property equal to 0, therefore del q by t is less than or equal to 0. Cyclic integral of del q by t is less than or equal to 0. So this is what known as inequality of Clausius. This equation is known as inequality of Clausius, and it provides the criteria for the reversibility of the cycle. So the what is inequality of Clausius? Inequality of Clausius, cyclic integral of del q by t is less than or equal to 0. So we can take this is equal to, if del cyclic integral of del q by t equal to 0, the cycle is reversible. If cyclic integral of del q by t is less than 0, the cycle is irreversible and possible. When then the del q, cyclic integral of del q by t is greater than 0, the cycle is impossible. So whether the cycle is reversible cycle or irreversible cycle, that depends on that depends on the value of cyclic integral of del q by t. When this is equal to 0, the cycle is reversible. When it is less than 0, the cycle is irreversible and possible. When the cyclic integral of del q by t is greater than 0, the cycle is impossible. So this is the conclusion of inequality of Clausius. Then entropy principle. So we have ds is greater than del q by t. So that is what we have earlier defined from the Clausius theorem. We defined ds equal to del q, ds is greater than del q by t. For an isolated system which is not interacting with the surrounding, ds of isolated system is greater than or equal to 0. For isolated system, it is not interacting with the surrounding. So ds, change in entropy of the isolated system, is greater than or equal to 0. So for reversible process, ds of the isolated system equal to 0, that is s equal to constant. For irreversible process, ds of change in entropy of the isolated system is greater than 0. So the entropy of an isolated system can never decrease. This is known as principle of increase of entropy or entropy principle. So from the two statements, for the change in entropy for isolated system is equal to 0 for reversible process. If the process is reversible, the change in entropy for isolated system is equal to 0, that is s equal to constant. For an irreversible process, right, ds of isolated system, ds, change in entropy of isolated system, is greater than 0. So whether this is ds equal to 0 or greater than 0, so the entropy of an isolated system can never decrease, and this is known as principle of increase of entropy, or simply principle of entropy principle. So the entropy of an isolated system always increases and becomes a maximum value at the state of equilibrium condition. Then since the entropy of an isolated system can never decrease, it follows that only those processes are possible in nature which would give an increase in entropy increase for the system and the surrounding together. So for any system, any process, the entropy of the system and the surrounding, or that is universe, entropy of the universe is keep on increasing. All spontaneous process in nature occur only in one direction, from higher to lower potential, and these are accompanied by the entropy increase in the entropy increase of the universe. So the reversible process is only hypothetical. All the natural process are irreversible. All the irreversible process, they are occurring from higher potential to lower potential, and this is accompanied by increase in entropy of the universe. A process always occur in such a direction as to cause an increase in entropy of the universe. So whenever there is a thermodynamic process that is causing increase in entropy of the universe. So thus the second law of thermodynamics indicates the direction in which a process takes place. So that is why the second law of thermodynamics is called as directional law. So this is giving the direction in which the process is occurring, always from higher potential to the lower potential. And the entropy change in various thermodynamic processes. So we have the constant volume process. So S2 minus S1 equal to MCV into logarithmic of P2 by P1, or which is also equal to MCV into logarithmic of T2 by T1. And constant pressure process, S2 minus S1 change in entropy equal to MCP into logarithmic of V2 by V1, which is equal to MCP into logarithmic of T2 by T1. For constant temperature process, S2 minus S1 equal to MR into logarithmic of P2 by P1, which is equal to MR into logarithmic of V2 by V1. And for adiabatic process, there is no change in the entropy, S2 minus S1 equal to 0, or S1 equal to S2. For polytropic process, using any of the three equations, we can calculate the change in entropy. S2 minus S1 equal to M into CV into logarithmic of T2 by T1 plus R into logarithmic of V2 by V1, or M into CV into logarithmic of P2 by P1 plus CP into logarithmic of V2 by V1, or M into CP into logarithmic of T2 by T1 minus R into logarithmic of P2 by P1. So, using any one of these equations, depending on the availability of properties, we can calculate the change in entropy of the polytropic process. Then entropy generation, we define the entropy generation. The entropy increase due to the internal irreversibility is called as entropy generation. So any process is an irreversible process. So the irreversibility of a process is due to the disorderly movement of molecule within the system. So that is what causing the entropy generation. So any thermodynamic process is accompanied by the entropy generation, given by entropy generation equal to S2 minus S1. This is the change in entropy of any particular process minus integral 1 to 2 del Q by T. So where S2 minus S1 is the entropy change of a particular process, and del Q by T, integral del Q by T is the entropy transfer. So the entropy generation equal to the change in entropy of a process minus integral del Q by T, or entropy transfer during the process. The second law states that any thermodynamic process is accompanied by entropy generation. So the entropy generation depends on the path of the system followed. So that also we have to remember, and the amount of entropy generation quantifies the intrinsic irreversibility of a process. So what kind of turbulence, what kind of disturbance occurring, irreversibility or disorderly movement of the molecule occurring within the system during a particular process, that is the measure of the internal entropy generation. Then we take the third law of thermodynamics. So the third law of thermodynamics states, when a system is at a zero absolute temperature, the entropy of a system is zero. When a system is at zero absolute temperature, the entropy of the system is equal to zero. Then there is another statement. The third law of thermodynamics stated as follows. The entropy of all perfect crystalline solid is zero at absolute zero temperature. This is another statement of the third law of thermodynamics. We have third statement of the third law of thermodynamics. So it is impossible by any procedure, no matter how idealized, to reduce any system to an absolute zero temperature in a finite number of operations. So it is impossible, generally it is impossible by any procedure to reduce the temperature of the system to absolute zero temperature in a finite number of operations. So, this is what the statement of third law of thermodynamics. So, we have a reflection spot. We try to answer few questions based on the discussion of the 15 minutes. The inequality of Clausius, the Clausius inequality equation provides the criterion of the reversibility of a cycle. Say true or false. So, the statement is true. Clausius inequality that is used to classify the property, classify a particular cycle, whether this is reversible or irreversible or impossible cycle. Entropy of an isolated system can never decrease. They say true or false. The statement is again true. Second law indicates the direction in which the process takes place. The answer again true. Entropy generation depends on path of the system followed. Again the answer is true. The amount of entropy generation quantifies the intrinsic irreversibility of a process. Again the answer is true. So, these are all the statements from the previous discussion. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I referred for preparing the slides. You can also refer to it for additional information. And thank you for watching. This is my mail ID. You can write to my mail ID for any clarification or queries. Thank you for watching and we'll meet again.